morning and welcome to Fellowship Online. We are so very excited to have you here with us this morning. And listen, if you need to recharge, if you need to be refueled, this service is the one for you. So here at Fellowship Church, it is our endeavor to love God, love people, and impact the world. And after a word of prayer, we're going to jump right into our service.
Bow your heads with me. Kind Father, we thank you so much for today. We thank you for the opportunity that we have right now to meet you and worship, God. I pray even now that wherever it is that we're sitting, wherever it is that we are, that your spirit would meet us here, Lord God. That in the worship, Lord God, we would experience you afresh, Lord God. That it would be something that would rejuvenate our very souls, Lord God. And I pray that the word, Lord God, would speak life to our situations. That the word would accomplish what the word of God says that it will. That it would encourage, Lord God. That it would be a healing balm, Lord God. That it would be a source of deliverance, Lord. So we set out our cups and we prepare our hearts to receive all that you have for us today. So it's with great expectation that we pray all these things in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen and amen.
Amen.
Let's get ready to worship God.
And God, we thank you on tonight. And if you can lift up a sound in your own way, just to lift up a reverence of thanks to the Father on tonight. Hallelujah. We worship you on tonight, God. Hallelujah. God, we thank you. God, we reverence you on tonight, God. It could have been another way, Lord. It could have been another way, God. Hallelujah. Lord, receive our worship on today. Hallelujah. This is for you, God. This is for you, God. Receive our worship. Receive our praise on today. Hallelujah. God, we thank you. God, we thank you for your blood. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Like that, they thank hallelujah, and we're here for him on tonight. Hallelujah.
Who is worthy? Is that okay? Come on, repeat after me. Listen. Say, oh.
You're my everything.
But we're not dead.
You're my everything.
I said we made. joy and sorrow. You're my hope for tomorrow. Hey, see, you're my everything. See, everything, everything. Say 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 you're my everything. Say you're my everything. You're my everything. Everybody in this house, clap your hands right there.
Praise the Lord. Welcome back. I hope that you felt the Spirit of God in your home, in your various respective places, wherever you are, to just remind yourself that there is none like God. Amen. Now listen, if that's something that's lingering with you even now, maybe that's something you want to revisit throughout the week. Maybe that's a moment that you want to share with family or friends. There are ways for you to stay connected with us, to access that worship, to access the word that Pastor Tony is about to preach to us throughout the week on demand whenever you need it. So if you look at the bottom of your screen, there are links and ways to stay connected with us. We have a Facebook, we have Instagram, we have YouTube, we have an app, and of course you can always go to our website. So please definitely connect with us throughout the week.
And now, y'all, it's time for offering. Time to be able to give. If the Lord has blessed you to be able to be a blessing, we want to give you the opportunities and ways in which you can partner with us in all the things that we're doing to love God, love people, and impact the world, not just in word, but also in deed. And so here's some ways that you can give. The first way that you can give, for all the members, you already know about the Band app. If you don't have it, download it. Not only will you get great announcements, but there's also ways to give there. Secondly, there's going to be a link in the chat box right below. And then lastly, super easy, is our text to give function. All you do is find the number on the screen. All you do is text the word give, put a space, and then the amount you'd like to give. We thank you so much for your donations. Thank you so much for partnering with us.
Hallelujah. God, receive it. Receive it on tonight. God, to go into your presence. We posture ourselves, God, to worship you in spirit and in truth. Holy Spirit, have your way. We're here for you, God. Yes, we are, Jesus. You made a way. When our backs were against the wall, and it looked as if it was over, Lord, you made a way. Is that anybody's testimony? And we're saying, let's say that again, y'all. this year we're going to continue to look to you, God. You are the source of our strength. You are the strength of my life. Pastor Tony said, when it's all said and done, when it's all said and done, God, I want you to know that I loved you with my whole heart. That you are a delight. It was a delight to honor and be your child. That you took good care of me, Jesus. When it's all said and done, we want to leave this earth and know, God, that you've been pleased with the sacrifice, the little bit that you gave us to give back. We are the offering. God, we give you our hearts. We give you our mind. The Word of God says to love you with your whole heart, soul, strength, everything that you got. Lay it all at His feet.
To see things like
God, we look to you.
Can somebody lift your hands? Pastor Cooper and Lady Cooper upstairs. And they are, you know, beginning to feel the weight of the call. And I told them, well, that's interesting. I feel lighter. the two separate couples going opposite directions through a gateway are feeling two opposite things. I'm feeling lighter because there is a blessing in obedience. I want everybody to understand that there is a blessing in obedience. God didn't say it would be easy, but there's a blessing in obedience. And there was no greater feeling than knowing that you have done the will of the Father. And God may never ask you to do something this weighty or this heavy, but just know, whatever the requirement is, there's always safety in being obedient to God. So I want you to know that this is a thing that is not easy. It's not easy, is it, babe? It's not easy. I want you to know I love you with a godly love. This place has shaped and formed me as to who I am. My wife was 19 years old when she started coming here. It has shaped who she is. I want you to know this will always be home. I know if I can't go nowhere else in the world, I can always come home. Can I? You to know that anything that we're going to do around the world, they're going to hear fellowship. Anything that people will be blessed on any stage. I'm not a person that forgets where they come from. And so my heart is sad and full at the same time. It would be selfish for me to stay beyond my assignment, because then I would be operating in my flesh and not in my grace. And it would be selfish for you all to want to keep us here, because you wouldn't be getting the full measure of what God has for you, because the grace is lifted for the assignment. So God never said it would be easy, but he always says that it will be worth it. And I want you to know that this is worth it. Whatever God asks you to give up, he's got more for you. And so I just want to bless this house for the last 20 minutes that I'm pastoring. I want to bless this house. I want to bless the man and woman of God who's going to lead this house. And I want it to be recorded what true kingdom transfer looks like. No schism, no strife, no struggle. People are like, what? What? It's so odd because people are so used to stuff being going on. But this is the Lord's work. I've cried so many tears, I can't cry no more. So don't mistake my lack of emotion for, oh, he ready to get up. No, I don't have no more tears to cry. We don't have any more tears to cry. We are sober to the fact that it is time. It is just time. When God says time, it's time. And so, first I'm going to do, I just want to speak over this house that has raised me, this house that has made me, this house that has allowed me to make mistakes and act wild and refine what God has called me to do. I bless this house. I bless this ground. I bless the doorposts. I bless every fiber of carpet. I bless every seat. And I pronounce a blessing over this house. I pronounce worldwide impact coming from this house. I pronounce influence all over the world from this house. Yes, God. Full to enhance vision. God, we thank you for laborers, even in a pandemic. God, I thank you for exponential growth, even in a pandemic, when churches are reducing and cutting staff and losing membership and people are falling off. God, I thank you, Lord, that this place bucks the trend right now in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for overflow. Thank you, Lord, for what you allowed me to do. Thank you, Lord, for you allowed me to lead. Thank you, Lord, for the dark days you allowed me to lead this ministry through. But it can stand on its feet now. It's no longer an ICU. It's no longer on the edge of calamity and death, God. It's healthy now. So, God, I release. Yes, God. This work. Thank you, Lord, for using me. Thank you, Lord, for using my wife. Thank you, Lord, for using my children. Thank you, Lord, for allowing us to be on the front edge of miracles and lives changed. So, God, I release. Knowing, Lord, it was never my work. It was me managing your work. God, I bless this house. Bless every member and partner of this house. That they are healthy. They are wealthy. They are wise. They are lacking nothing. They are whole in every area. Lord, bless the people of this house. Lord, I'm partial to this house. I always want to see home do well. So, Lord, I thank you that when the next time we break this threshold, that won't be a parking space left. I thank you, Lord, that it'll be the third service of the day. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, I leave this place better than how I found it. And Lord, I thank you, Lord, that my successor will complete his assignment better than how he found it. Lord, there's not a jealous bone in my body. God, I want him to do well. I want him to do well. For when he does well, the kingdom does well. So, Lord, we thank you for it. In Jesus' name. I'm going to ask Lady Tiffany, yes?
God, I just thank you for every prophecy, everything that has been spoken again over this house, God. I just thank you, God, that we will continue to be people who love you with their whole heart and strength. God, that the purpose, the kingdom assignment, God, is to love people, God, to impact the world and to love God in the name of Jesus, God. We are, this place is here because of you. God, I thank you that we never get puffed up in the name of Jesus, but oh, God, that we will not be a reproach on your name and to be a reproach on holiness, God. Let, again, all the more let love manifest in this place, God. Teach us how to draw people. Teach us how to win the souls. Teach us, God, what to do, when to do it, how to say it in the name of Jesus, God. Check us in the name of Jesus. It's too many damaged people, God. Too many people searching for hope in the name of Jesus. So when fellowship is named, comes up in the name of Jesus, God, let it be a place, God, a refuge, a place of safety, a place of peace, of joy and love, God, where all the needs are met, God. We thank you. We thank you, God, again, for being able to move forward. And God, I thank you. Not only all that, people will come here and get delivered and set free. People will come here and be filled with your Holy Spirit, God. because it is your spirit that leads, teaches, and guides to all truth and understanding. When all the world is trying to calm up and say, what God is this and all these other things, God, let them know, even through this place, God, that there is only one true and living God, and that's the God that we serve. And the God, manifest yourself. Manifest yourself, God. It ain't all in what we say and talking, but God, let your power be demonstrated by the things that go forth from this place, God. So I thank you that it stays rooted and grounded in your love, rooted and grounded in your word. Rooted and grounded in you. You are the creator. You are the potter. And I thank you that you shape everything according to you. Hallelujah, God. It is a privilege and it is an honor. Hallelujah. And all that, just to be a part in all that you're doing, God. And as I always say, God, we'll forever give you glory. We'll forever give your name praise. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Pastor and Lady Cooper, if y'all come right here. I want some men of God, if you would stand behind them. We've blessed a house. We've blessed a building. We've blessed a ministry. But we'd be remiss if we don't bless you. Behind them. Can I have another brother up here? Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Gore. Bless the house. But I'd be remiss if I don't bless you. There is a great lineage that you are about to step into. Stepping into this office, in this place, I can't speak for every house, but there was a mantle on this house. And so I thank God that you're about to step into that mantle. So you'll start hearing things that you never heard before. You'll start seeing things that you never seen before. There'll be things that you'll have a concept of that your wife will already be travailing and praying for. That is the lineage that is passed down from my mother and father through us, and that mantle is about to come on you. It's not to erase. I know you all come from anointed people and all those things. It's not an either or, it's a both and. And God is about to expand your grace. Can somebody put your hands this way? God's about to expand your grace. He's about to expand your thinking. He's about to expand your capacity. He's about to expand your understanding of Scripture. He's about to understand your gifting. There's healing mantle in this house, and healing the mantle is about to come on you. Shift atmospheres is about to come on you. The anointing of discernment is about to come on you. Sister Emily, a heavy weight of prayer and travail and seeing around the corner in the spirit is about to come on you. Let me release you. You don't have shoes to fill. You have a mandate to fulfill. Let me release you of the weight. You do not have shoes to fill. You have a mandate to fulfill. I release you of my shadow. I release you of my shoes. I release you of my expectation. You run your race. As God has called you, I'm available to you if you need anything. You know that. But I release you to do what God has called you to do, to walk in the footsteps that God has called you to lead. My assignment is finished, and I release you, man of God and woman of God. Boldness, go with confidence, knowing that God is with you. And if God be for you, who can be against you? against you. I call people from the north, east, south, and west to join you at the side to grab your vision. In the name of Jesus. We bind up strife. We bind up resistance. We bind up obstinance. We bind up stiff-neckedness. And we release cooperation. We release harmony. We release unity. We release resource into the man and the woman of God. Lord, astound them. Lord, let him, when he open his mouth, God, you take over and take him somewhere else. Lord, disturb his messages like you disturbed mine, God. Let him see the other side of Scripture. Thank you, Lord, for the wisdom of Solomon being on him right now. Right now, God, we bless. We bless. Lord, we touch them in the mind. Lord, it's with the mind that we serve you. So I thank you, Lord, that the man of God and the woman of God think with clarity, without timidity. Thank you, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord, that they hear you like they've never heard you. They hear you like they've never heard you. They see you. They walk in this room and they see things that I never saw. Thank you, Lord, for vision in the name of Jesus. Lord, I bless their bodies. I bless their bodies. Lord, that you keep them healed, that you keep them whole. We bind up sickness. We bind up genetic things that pass down. We thank you right now with long life, they're going to serve you. We bind up hypertension. We bind up arthritis. We bind up cardiovascular in the name of Jesus. And Lord, we bless them. Lord, there's a heavy work they got to do, Lord. They can't do it sick, God. So Lord, we thank you, Lord. Lord, we bless everything, Lord, that their hand touches, God. Lord, we thank you, Lord, not only their bodies, Lord, but the fruit of their body. Yes, God. Yes, God. Yes, God. Lady Tiff, Lady Tiff, Lady Tiff, in the name of Jesus, we bless the fruit of their bodies. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Ekenobosata. Stretch your hand this way. God, we speak unmerited favor and grace over the Coopers right now. There is nothing that they have need of that is not already on its way. I thank you, Lord, for the grace to lead. I thank you, Lord, for the grace. He already has power, God, but I thank you, Lord, for grace. Thank you, Lord, for unity, that there will be no division amongst them. That he will start a thought and she'll finish it. Thank you, Lord, for the men of God that's going to surround him. Thank you, Lord, for the women of God that's going to surround her and undergird her and pray for her and follow her. Thank you, Lord, that this is just a beginning. This is just a beginning. This is just a beginning. So, Lord, we thank you for what you've done. Thank you, Lord, for what you're about to do. Astound us. Astound us. God bless my people. Lord, all these are my people. God bless my people. Bless my people. Bless my people, God. Bless my people. Do something extraordinary with my people. Let it be said that the anointing not only is still here, but it has increased. That you have turned the temperature up on the fire on this house. God, we bless you. We love you. And we're excited about what you're about to do. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. And amen. Can somebody put your hand together? Joey. It's something that I want to give you. It's something that was given to me by my father. He gave this to me when I was installed as pastor. And it's a sword representing the Spirit of God, the Word of God. It's a, when you pull it out, I'm going to pull it out now for safety, but it's a double-bladed sword. Fight you're gonna have, but the victories that you're gonna have. Come here, baby. And so we together are gonna give you. Ain't no magic in it. Because the gift is in you. And as our assignment is ending, we're giving this to you as a grace token of what God is about to do in you. So we humbly submit it to you. And we thank God, we bless y'all. I want y'all to put your hands together. And I want you to welcome your new pastor and your new first lady.
I want to do this as we're approaching the end of a year. Everybody, you can stay seated. Just lift your hands right now. Just lift those hands right now. As we're ending this year, I decree and declare that this moment is not just the end of a year. Get ready for this, but it is an end of an era. For all the years, for all the moments that you've dealt with, the things that you've faced, the challenges that you've faced, the things that you've struggled with, I want to declare tonight that even as we're stepping into a new year, somebody declare, I'm stepping into a new me. This is the end of an era. I do not care about the fact that the pandemic still exists. I decree and declare that God will allow you right now to step into a new moment, into a new season. Let me speak this over somebody, into a new life. I decree it and I declare it, that God is getting ready to do it. Somebody declare, God is getting ready to do it. As a matter of fact, the clock just struck midnight. Somebody declare, it's already done. So I want to say this to you, Happy New Year and Happy New Life. Because I declare that just like that, it doesn't have to be too much, but just like that, in the blink of an eye, God's getting ready to change your entire life. So can you just look at somebody and tell them, Happy New Year, Happy New You, congratulations. I'm stepping into a new life. Is anybody glad about the fact that you've made it to a new year? and you made it to a new you. Congratulations and Happy New Year.
With me, dear God, we ask for your spirit. We acknowledge that we can't do it by ourselves, that we are just sinners in need of a Savior. And we thank you that through your Son, Jesus Christ, we have a Savior, that we have access to the Father. So we accept that. We believe that story right now. And Lord God, we admit and we repent, Lord God, from the ways in which we weren't trusting you with our whole lives. And now we want to move forward with you being our Lord, with you being our Savior, with us being in submission to your will and your way for our life. And God, we look forward to spending an eternity with you. It is in Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen.
Amen. Well, you all, we have come to the end of our service. I do pray that you've been able to take away some nuggets that have strengthened you now and will continue to strengthen you throughout the week. Remember, take Jesus with you and do it on purpose in every single thing that you do, and that's how you'll get those results. So until we see you again next week,
bye.
Take care.